हेलो स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू क्लास फिफ्थ इंग्लिश ग्रामर यूट्यूब वीडियो। आई होप यू ऑल मस्ट बी फिट एंड फाइन। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर नंबर 9 फ्रॉम ग्रामर गेट बुक एंड द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर नंबर 9 इज एडवर्ब्स। आई नो यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड अबाउट एडवर्ब्स इन योर प्रीवियस क्लासेस, सो लेट अस स्टार्ट द चैप्टर एडवर्ब्स। So an adverb describes a verb, an adjective or another adverb. In other words, we can say that an adverb is a part of a speech which qualifies a verb, an adjective or another adverb. It tells us how, where, when, how much and with what frequency. In this picture you can see there are some boxes are there, some colored boxes are there, some sentences, some words are written, and these words are used as adverb in a sentence. When they are used in a sentence on a special place, then they act as a adverb. They tells us how, where, when, how much, how often. Now secondly, adverbs are categorized in 5 types. You can count on your fingertips: manner, adverb of manner, adverb of place, adverb of time, adverb of frequency, and adverb of degree. These are the 5 types of the adverb. Now we will discuss about each type of adverb in detail. So firstly, adverb of time. Here are some words which are used as adverb to show adverb of time: already, ago, before, yet, never, or yesterday, soon, and so many are there. I have some examples are there, you can see. I have seen this before. So it is telling a time when he has seen, so before. I have not seen him since. It is also telling a time. Now come to adverb of frequency. There are also some words are there: always, usually, normally, often, sometimes, occasionally. So these are also used with adverb of frequency. Some examples are also there: it's always cold in this room, I normally go to the gym, they often go out for dinner. Means they are telling a frequency, means how often. It is answering a question: how often. Now next, adverb of place. Here, everywhere, near, nearby, down, away, they are telling a place. So is that your scarf there? I have lived here for about 2 years. Next, adverb of manner. These are slowly, badly, delightfully, loudly. These are the words which shows adverb of manner. The soldiers fought bravely. How they fought? They fought bravely. In what manner they fought? They fought bravely. She dresses beautifully. In what manner she dresses? She dresses beautifully. Next, adverb of degree. It shows almost, fully, rather, quite, to. It is showing a degree, means it answers the question: how much. I am fully prepared, I am rather busy. So how much I am prepared? I am fully prepared. She is almost 30, like that only. Now we will discuss about each type in of slight detail. So adverb of manner first. Adverb of manner, these adverbs say how something happens, means they answer the question that how something happens. Nearly all adverbs ending in ly are adverbs of manner. You can see, you can easily identify that it is adverb of manner. How? You can see words like easily, happily, loudly, quickly, quietly, sadly. you can see it, all words are ending with ly, so we can easily identify them, and they answer the question how. Some examples are there. He drives carefully. Now the adverb carefully says that how he drives. The sun shines brightly. The adverb brightly says the how the sun shines. So it is ending in ly, so it is showing adverb of manner. Now next, adverb of place. These adverbs say where something happens, means it is showing, it shows the place, they answer the question where, means just like words like away, everywhere, here, near, inside, outside are some of the example of adverb of place. For example, Mr. Bose lives there. Now the adverb there says where Mr. Bose lives, means it is telling answer where, answer where. Now the accident happened here. The adverb here says where the accident happened. Next, they went out. The adverb out says where they went. Next, adverb of time. These adverbs say when something happens. These tells time. They answer the question when. Just like words like after, before, early, now, since, soon, today are some of the example of adverbs of time. Some examples are there. She was surfing the internet yesterday. Now the adverb yesterday says when she was surfing the internet. It is telling the time. We will know the result tomorrow. The adverb tomorrow says when we will know the results. Next, now adverb of frequency. These adverbs say how often something happens. Means how often means in what frequency they happen. They happen regularly, they happen sometimes, like this. They answer the question how often. Words like always, every day, frequently, never, often, once, seldom are some of the examples of adverb of frequency. Some examples are there. Patrick always tells the truth. How often he tells the truth? He always tells the truth. She often uses the internet. How often she uses the internet? She often uses the internet. We sometimes watch cartoons. It is telling a frequency. So these are adverb of frequency. Now next, adverb of degree. Now adverbs vary and quite answer the questions how much or to what degree. Such adverbs are called adverbs of degree. Means they answer the question how much or to what degree. Most of these adverbs are used before adjectives or other adverbs to add to their meaning. Means they are usually used before adjectives or another adverb. Words like fairly, rather, fully, completely, slightly, nearly, almost, and some words more are there, are some of the example of the adverb of degree. Just like the food is really delicious. To what degree the food is delicious? The food is really delicious. How much food is delicious? The food is really delicious. Like this. He types very carefully. She means he types careful. How much? How she types? He types very carefully. Some also examples are also there. The glass is nearly full. How much the glass is full? The glass is nearly full. Now, one point is to note that in these sentences, the sentences which are given here, I am rather tired, thank you very much, the glass is nearly full, your answer is slightly different. Now, in these sentences, the adverb of degree are used before adjectives or adverbs and add to their meaning. Means they are used before adjectives or adverbs, as I told you earlier. Another adverb of degree can also add to the meaning of a verb. Means they are also used to qualify a verb, as in the sentences below. They fully supported me. Means to what extent they are supporting me? They fully supported me. They are telling a degree. So they fully supported me. Now, I hope you have understood that all the five types of the adverb. Now, as we studied in adjective, the degrees of the adverb adjective. Now, here are also degrees of adverbs also. There are three degrees of comparison of adverbs: the positive, the comparative, and the superlative. To understand this, let us read these sentences. Sentence number 1, 2, 3. Sheen walks fast. Umar walks faster than Sheen. John walks the fastest. Now, according to definition of if you want to know the difference between the degrees of adjective and degrees of adverb, you must have to remember the definition of adjective. The adjective is a part of a speech that qualifies a noun or a pronoun. Means an adjective is used only before a noun or pronoun, but an adverb can qualify adjective, verb, adverb. They are not used before noun or pronoun. So these are the difference. Now in these sentences you can see Sheen walks fast. Fast is used as an adverb. Umar walks faster. Faster means it is making a comparison. Now in sentence number 1, the adverb fast is in the positive degree, as no comparison is being made. In sentence number 2, the adverb faster is in comparative degree, as the action of the two people are being compared. Means they are comparing. In sentence number 2 is Umar and Sheen are being compared with each other. So it is the faster is used. Now next, sentence number 3, you can see the adverb fastest is in the superlative degree, as the action of one person is being compared to that of more than two. Means more than two people, the action is compared with more than two people. So it is in the superlative degree. As we all know, in adjective it is also like that. But there are some rules of forming comparative degree of comparison of adverbs. Let us see these rules. Rule number 1. The comparative degree of an adverb is usually formed by adding er. Means they are formed by adding er, and the superlative degree by adding est. For example, you can see below: fast, faster, and fastest. Hard, harder, hardest. Early, earlier, earliest. However, some spelling changes are there. You can see in early, E-A-R-L-Y. Now, the spelling has been changed. E-A-R-L-I-E-E-R. Now, the spelling has been changed. So, these are the rules for rule number 1. For making comparative and superlative degree. Now, the comparative and superlative, rule number 2, the comparative and superlative degrees of many adverbs are formed by adding more and most. They are mostly words ending with in ly. Means the words which mostly the words which you which end in ly are being made comparative and superlative by adding more and most. Means slowly. So we add more slowly, most slowly. Means more slowly is the comparative and most slowly is the superlative. carefully, more carefully, most carefully, happily, more happily, most happily, like that. Some exceptions are also there. Often, more often, means ly is not there in often. So we don't change it. We use often, more often, most often, like that. So I hope you have understood this chapter. And if any doubt is there, then please ask in the comment box. Thank you.